Okay, this lesson is actually the third part in a three-part video on energy work power. As mentioned in the previous lesson, power is not mentioned in all these three lessons. The name energy work power is just the name of the chapter. So in the future lessons, I will touch on power. Okay, so let's look at the content again. We have already studied about conservation of energy and efficiency. And we also touch on work done. So in this lesson, we're going to talk about gravitational potential energy and kinetic energy. So what is gravitational potential energy? In the previous lesson, we already explained that gravitational potential energy is a form of work done. So this is just a recap. So gravitational potential energy, or GPE, that now I'm going to use this term GPE, is the energy stored in a body due to its vertical position. Alright, so GPE is also the equation is mass times gravitational field strength times height, and GPE is only dependent on the vertical height. That means that if a body is dropped by in a distance of a height of h meters, then the GPE is simply mg times h. So let's move on to kinetic energy. So what is kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is the energy that an object possesses due to its motion. Okay, that means that any object with some velocity has kinetic energy. So the formula for kinetic energy, or Ke, is half mv squared. Alright, what is m? M is the mass in kg, v is velocity in meter per second. Alright, so you must remember it's v squared, not v. Alright, so this is a diagram of the motion. So what's the relationship between GPE and Ke? How do they interchange their energy? Okay, let's look at two examples. What happens when you drop a ball from a height? And what happens if you throw the same ball vertically up with a certain velocity? Okay, let's look at these two diagrams. Let's say you drop a ball from A and it falls to a point, lowest point, say B. And another example is throw a ball up with a vertical height of a vertical velocity of V, and it reaches a maximum height of B. Okay, in the first case, in the initial part, there will be a maximum GPE. Let's say we give an example of 100 joules. Okay, because at the highest point A, the object is at rest, so that means that the Ke is zero. So what happens is when you release the object at A, alright, it's going to fall down, and then the energy of GP is going to be converted to Ke. So eventually when it reaches lowest point, the GP becomes zero and all the energy is converted to Ke. Okay, so what happens if, let's say we consider a point in the middle. Let's say we want to consider here. Let's say it has just dropped halfway. If it has just dropped halfway, then the GPE will be equal to 50 joules, because half of the energy is converted. So that means that the Ke will be also 50 joules. So in all three cases, you realize that the total energy remains the same. First case, it adds up to be 100 joules. Second case, 100. Third case, 100. So that's why energy is conserved. It is just transfer from one form to another as it falls from GPE to Ke. So in the same way, alright, when you throw an object up, initially it has 100 joules of Ke and 0 joules of GPE. When it reaches highest point where there is no velocity at that moment, alright, in time, the Ke becomes zero, alright, and the GPE becomes maximum. So all the Ke that was initially present has been transferred or converted to GPE. If let's say I want to study a position which is 25% of the final height here, then we will expect that you will only have 25% of the final GPE, and then the K will be 75% of it. So you look at this example again. If you add up the energies of GPE and K in each case, it g- gives you 100%. So the total energy remains constant. It's just that energy is converted from one form to another. Conservation of energy holds. Okay, so let's look at another example, a pendulum. So if a pendulum swings from point A to point B to point C, okay, at point A, it has a maximum GPE and a minimum KE of zero. So what happens when it goes to the lowest point, which is B? When it reaches lowest point, alright, all the GPE is converted to KE. So there's a change of the energy transferring to KE. But then when the pendulum goes back to the highest point C, again the KE is reconverted back to GPE. So the energy is exchanged between these two forms, but the total energy remains the same. Alright, so in order to appreciate this GPE and KE relationship, it is best to do some questions related to them. So I would like to do this first question first, then after that, in the second question, I would like you to try on your own. Okay, so I will start with this first question. Okay, a ball of mass 2 kg is dropped from a height of 10 meters. What is the velocity when it reached the ground? So in order to do questions related to GPE and KE, the first thing is that you need to write down the energy conversion that takes place. So if let's say a ball is dropped from a 10 meter height, what's the initial energy, input energy or initial energy that it has? Obviously, you only have one kind of energy, which is GPE. Okay, because it's released from rest. So there's no other form of energy but GPE. So what happened is this GPE is converted to what? When it reaches the ground, all the GPE is expanded to KE. So the energy conversion that you're going to write is GPE is equal to, is converted to KE. So in other words, if you simplify this equation, it becomes mgh, okay, is equal to half mv squared. So you realize that once you have the energy conversion out, you can convert this energy conversion into a formula relating the formula of GPE and KE. Once you have this formula, you can solve the question easily. So it'll be 2 times 10 times 10, alright, equal to half times 2 times v squared. So let's try this together. So v squared is equal to 200. So what's the answer? The answer will be, let me check, 14.1 meter per second. Right, so that's how you solve for it. So I want you to try the second question yourself first. Okay, once you found the answer, then you press pause first, then after you find the answer, you just release the pause. Okay, so have you found the answer already? So let us do this together. So first of all, again, you must draw the energy conversion. In this case, you're throwing a ball upwards, so it's going to be start with KE and then it becomes GPE. So using this energy conversion, you can actually write down the formula, which is half mv squared is equal to mgh. So half times 0.5 times phi square is equal to 0.5 times 10 times h. So let's solve for this. So what do I get? So I get 25 divided by 2 divided by 10, which gives you 1.25 meters, right? So that's the answer. Okay, so I hope that you got the same answer as me. Okay, once you finish this, let's go to something more difficult. So the diagram shows how a ball is rolled down a ramp, is released from rest or from the top. So calculate the final speed at the bottom of the ramp, assuming no friction. So again, you will have to try to use the energy conversion, but you may pause the video at this point in time. Okay, so have you solved the question? If you have solved the question, let's do it together. So the energy conversion is going to be GPE at the top to KE at the bottom. Right, so the GPE is going to be MGH is equal to half MV squared. So your M times 10. Now you realize this. Okay, do we use 5, 3 or 4 for the H? Obviously, we only use 3 because only the vertical height matters for GPE. So you don't care about the path taken. So you become half times 2 times V squared. Okay, so we cancel this. What do we get? V squared is equal to 60, so V is equal to 7.75 meter per second. Alright, so I hope you got the same answer as me. Okay, let's move on. Now, I'm going to use this example to show you different levels of difficulty of energy conversion question. This is so-called level 1. Okay, in the previous three questions, it's a very straightforward energy conversion examples. But what if you have something that is a little bit special? Alright, you need to go back to your basic principles, because you cannot always say the energy conversion is GPE equal KE or KE equal GPE. That's too easy already. Alright, so in this case, I'm saying that the 500 kg carriage is released from A. What's the final velocity at B? So you must be very careful here. So you must remember that energy conversion is the total energy in the beginning to the total energy at the end. So the total energy in the beginning, first of all, the carriage is not moving, so there is only GPE. Alright, so the total energy in the beginning is just GPE at A for the carriage. So finally at B, alright, you will have KE, right? Obviously, because it is at the lower height, so some of the GPE will become KE at B. But then you realize that because B is still 30 meters from the lowest point, if you take the lowest point as no GPE, then obviously there will still be some GPE at B. So this is the trick, you see, you need to be very careful. The total energy in at the end is a sum of KE and GPE, not only KE because of the presence of some height. Alright, so if you simplify this, alright, it's going to be MGH, HA, let's say, which is the first height, is equal to half MV squared plus MGHB. Okay, so in other words, the 500 kg times 10 times HA is going to be 50 meters is equal to half times 500 V squared plus 500 times 10 times 30. So let's simplify by removing the 500 first. So you realize that V squared over 2 will be equal to 500 minus 300, 200 here. So V will be equal to square root of 400, which gives you 20 meter per second. Alright, so I hope you got the same answer as me. So if you can solve this, let's go on to the next question. Alright, so now this is the level 2 question. Now what happens if we add velocity? That means that at A, there is an initial velocity. Okay, so in this case, the energy conversion will be a little bit more complicated. It will be GPE at A plus KE at A is equal to GPE at B plus KE at B, because there is a combination of GP and KE in the beginning, and then there's also a combination of GP and KE at the end. So let's calculate. So it's going to be MGHA plus half MV. Okay, let's call this VA square, which is a 10 meter per second, is equal to MGHB plus half MV squared. V squared is the final velocity here. Alright, so it's going to be 500 times 10 times 50 plus half times 500, sorry, times 10 squared equal to 500 times 10 times 30 plus half times 500, no space already, V squared. Alright, so let's simplify by removing all the 500. Okay, so what you have is 500 minus 300, okay, plus, so this one will be 50, right, because this is 10 square, which is 150, so you'll get half V squared equal to 250, so V is equal to square root of 500, right, square root of 500, so you get V is equal to 22.4 meter per second. Okay, if you have able to solve this, congratulations. So let's move on to the third one. Now I'm going to add something even more. Now not only it has an initial speed, but it has friction. Okay, you must remember that friction, okay, the distance moved is the path taken, not the height, not the horizontal distance, because friction keep changing direction along the path. Okay, so what's the energy conversion if we add all this together? Let's pause the video now. Okay, since you have already solved, let's do it together. So the energy conversion is just simply, okay, GP at A plus KE at A is equal to GP at B plus KE at B. Okay, then we add the friction. So I'll just simply call it friction, but it's actually work done against friction, due to friction, sorry. Okay, so this is the energy conversion. So again, let me skip the formula and go straight to the substitution, because there are just too many steps. So the MGH will be 500. Okay, I have to save a bit of space. MGH plus half times M times V squared is equal to MGH. Okay, plus half times M V square plus friction, which is 100 times 200. Alright, so let's solve this again. So I'm going to take a bit of time because there are a lot of things here. Alright, it's going to be a bit tough, so I hope you understand, because I'm also trying to do this question without actually okay finding an answer before that. Okay, so if I'm not wrong, I will get 250 V squared is equal to 105,000. So V will be equal to square root of 420, which gives you 20.5 meter per second. All right, so I hope that you're able to solve this. If you're able to solve this, basically you have already been able to solve most of the energy conversion questions. So if you still have any problem with energy conversion questions, you can let me know and I will try to post more videos on this. So that's all, and have a nice day. Thank you very much.